BOE may sell whole K portfolio in policy divergence from US Fed. Bloomberg, the Bank of England may sell all the UK government bonds bought under quantitative easing to better prepare for a future crisis, a move that would put it at odds with the US Federal Reserve. BOE Deputy Governor Dave Ramsden, who oversees financial markets, said officials may continue running down the K portfolio, which peaked at £895 billion, even after hitting the preferred minimum range of reserves. Marketmind, global monetary focus turns to New Zealand. A look at the day ahead in Asian markets. The Reserve Bank of New Zealand, sometimes seen as global monetary policy's canary in the coal mine, takes center stage in the Asia and Pacific region on Wednesday when it delivers its latest interest rate decision. Australia's January inflation data are also on tap. Annual inflation is expected to accelerate to 3.6% from 3.4%, and markets across the region should be relatively calm at the open after a quiet global session on Tuesday. Monthly Consumer Price Index Indicator. Key statistics. The monthly CPI indicator rose 3.4% in the 12 months to January. The most significant price rises were housing, plus 4.6%, food and non-alcoholic beverages, plus 4.4%, alcohol and tobacco, plus 6.7%, and insurance and financial services, plus 8.2%. What's new this month? Annual weight update of the CPI. A comprehensive update to the weights for the monthly CPI indicator has been implemented in January 2024 to ensure the weights used in the CPI basket reflect contemporary household spending patterns. The updated 2024 CPI weighting patterns can be found in annual weight update of the CPI and living cost indexes. For the quarterly CPI, the updated weights will be implemented in the March 2024 quarter. Construction work done, Australia, preliminary key statistics in seasonally adjusted terms in the December quarter. Total construction work done rose 0.7% to $65,440.5 million. Building work done fell 1.1% to $34,296.9 million. Engineering work done rose 2.7% to $31,143.5 million. The trend estimate for total construction work done rose 1.0%. Value of construction work done. Value of construction work done. Chain volume measures. Seasonally adjusted estimates. Monetary policy remains restrictive. Over the past year or so, the New Zealand economy has evolved broadly as anticipated by the committee. Core inflation and most measures of inflation expectations have declined, and the risk to the inflation outlook have become more balanced. However, headline inflation remains above the 1-3% target band, limiting the committee's ability to tolerate upside inflation surprises. Restrictive monetary policy and lower global growth have contributed to aggregate demand slowing to better match the supply capacity of the New Zealand economy. With high immigration and weaker demand growth, capacity constraints in the New Zealand labor market have eased. Thank you.